When it appeared a woman's kindness led to her death, it made national headlines. But as the story unraveled, a much more sinister narrative unfolded. In December 2018, Jacquelyn Smith was in a car in downtown Baltimore with her husband Keith when she reportedly noticed a woman with a sign that read, "Please help me feed my baby."
When a girl was out here with what looked like a baby in her hand, and it was raining, and my wife felt moved to give her some money. And when she did, some guy came over to say, "Can I thank her?" And as he did that, he commenced to stabbing my wife. He snatched her necklace before I knew it, and the girl snatched a little pocketbook in the seat, and they both ran.
Jacquelyn was stabbed at least 5 times in the torso and later died in the hospital. In the days that followed, Keith and his daughter, Valeria, tearfully recounted the incident to local news outlets.
"For the cowards that took my wife's life, I hope it was worth it, because you're going to answer to that one day. You're going to answer to it."
With Keith's help in describing the alleged attackers, a search ensued.
He's described as a man possibly in his 30s with a goatee. And we also want to identify the woman who was out there asking for money.
Jacquelyn's death stirred up fear, and the interim Baltimore police commissioner urged the public to be wary of other panhandlers.
They're using this ruse to get the attention of the would-be victim. We also want to caution the public about engaging with panhandlers and recognizing the fact that not all of them have honest intent. Not all of them are in real need.
The story gained nationwide attention. Celebrities like Oprah Winfrey tweeted about the tragedy, saying, "This story struck my heart. I've done this 1,000 times, but will think twice before ever doing it again."
Be careful when we see these panhandlers out and getting close proximity to your car, because like me, I'm from Baltimore. The last thing I thought that they were going to take my wife's life.
The real shock, however, came a few months after Jacquelyn's death. Police were having trouble corroborating Keith and Valeria's story. After being questioned further, the Smiths left their home in Baltimore.
He came in one night with a very large moving truck and rapidly loaded it the next day, and we never saw him since.
A number of holes in the pair's story, revealed through cell phone records, security cameras, and forensic evidence, led police to the conclusion that Keith and Valeria fabricated the story.
The information and the evidence points to it was not a panhandler.
Officials allege it was Jacquelyn's own husband and stepdaughter who killed her, saying Keith and Valeria tried to use negative perceptions of the city and its homelessness problems to mask the murder.
These individuals took advantage of a situation, a city that is already dealing with its own problems.
Meanwhile, Keith attempted to book one-way tickets out of the country for himself and his daughter, but they couldn't because they didn't have passports. The pair were found in Texas about 3 months after Jacquelyn's death and were arrested before crossing the Mexico border.
Mr. Smith and his daughter, Valeria Smith, were arrested and now have been charged with first-degree murder.
Their attorneys maintain their trip was unrelated and say no evidence links them to the crime.
Dad says, "Hey, you know what? Let's head on down to Mexico. Let's take a little family vacation, some R&R. I don't see there being any criminal element to that." And there is zero direct evidence linking Ms. Smith with any crime.
Up until the point that they decided to issue a warrant, they didn't have any other suspects. Mr. Smith is always innocent until proven guilty, and I haven't seen anything yet that proves guilty.
Jacquelyn's mother, on the other hand, had suspicions all along.
"It was all phony. I knew it wasn't real. I suspected that he had something to do with it. I said to him, 'I gave you my beautiful daughter and you let her die like that. But I know she didn't deserve to die the way she died. She was just a good, good person. She liked everybody.'"
In the aftermath of this horrible event, Baltimore is left tarnished by a stereotype regarding its impoverished citizens. A heartbroken family remains without answers, and Jacquelyn Smith is left without her life. We spoke with WBAL-TV reporter Jane Miller for more details on the investigation.
From the beginning, I must say there were questions about whether this really happened the way Keith, her husband, described it. I say that because the corner where this allegedly happened is not a big panhandling corner. It's a lightly traveled corner in East Baltimore. And folks on the block told me they were really surprised that this would have been a panhandler, so to speak, because they don't ever see anybody panhandling on that corner. And so this was treated with some fair amount of skepticism from the public.
So speaking of our two defendants, did Keith or Valeria have any criminal history of any kind?
Keith has an interesting history. He was involved in a series of bank robberies, and he hit the same bank three times, as a matter of fact. The way he was apprehended after that is that he led police on a chase and crashed into a city police car. When he was questioned about it and arrested, he said he was suffering from HIV. He said that he needed the money. That's why he robbed the same bank. So that's his history. Valeria does not have a significant record of any kind to speak of, but certainly the history of Keith Smith with that kind of financial crime in his background caught the attention of investigators.
What did the investigative team learn about an insurance policy?
We have reported that there is an insurance policy in which Keith Smith is the beneficiary. Does that form motive? Perhaps. I mean, does that play into what the investigators are looking at? Certainly. They always look at things that might provide a motive. There has been some activity in court on the civil side of this case because there's been a dispute over Jacquelyn Smith's biological children and Keith Smith in terms of getting control of the estate. There's been some discussion that Keith was concerned that she was going to leave him. She was talking about divorce. So things were not A-OK, apparently, in the relationship, you know, in the months leading up to this. The mother told me that the last time she saw them was, I think, Thanksgiving, which really wasn't that much long before this happened. And, you know, I didn't notice anything particularly unusual at that time, but had this feeling that something wasn't right. She didn't know Keith all that well. Jacquelyn has been married to Keith for, you know, last 15 years, 14 years, something like that.
Was there anything specific that led police to believe that Keith and Valeria's story was fabricated?
He gave them a scenario, and the scenario was that he and Jacquelyn and Keith's daughter were at a location in another part of the city for a party, and that they then left and drove to the home of the daughter, which was not far from where the stabbing allegedly happened, and that this happened on the way. So what detectives did is they looked at cameras all along that route and found no trace of the car. So that raised a question about whether he was being honest about the route. The other thing that they discovered when they looked at certain records related to his phone is that it appeared that he had made a stop along the way for about 15 minutes or so and didn't tell him about it. So there were inconsistencies in his story, allegedly, from the beginning that raised a lot of questions in their mind. And they used all of their kind of tools in the toolbox to investigate this case. The other thing that happened in the course of this investigation is that Keith Smith's brother provided detectives with some information that Keith was soliciting someone else to kill his wife.
Is there anything else that you want viewers to know about this story? It is a very interesting case.
I think the thing that is really fascinating about this case is the detective work that was done in this case. This is like what you see on the TV shows of Law and Order and CSI, etc. I mean, what they did in terms of tracking them, and, you know, they were arrested in Texas, not far from the border. So I think that the thing that really stands out is not just the beginning of the story where this ruse, unfortunately, was used to blame panhandlers, but then the work that was done by detectives to put this case together and to track them down before they were able to escape into Mexico.
In September 2019, Valeria pleaded guilty to acting as an accessory after the fact. Keith Smith is scheduled to stand trial in April 2020. We will pin any updates to their sentencing and trials in our comments section below. I'm Alexandra Stone, and this has been your Weekly Dispatch. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and like this video for more dispatches from the middle.